So hi guys, in this video I'm going to teach you how to deploy a machine learning model onto a web page. Alright, so make sure that you have watched my previous videos on Flask and getting started with that, because you'll need that to understand this. So this is the web page that I've created. This is basically used to predict the probability of a forest fire taking place. Alright, so the probability of a forest fire depends on three values: the temperature, the oxygen content in the air, and the humidity. Based on that, it's going to predict what are the chances of forest fire taking place. Alright, so the goal is you get the form data from your website, you send that to a Python program where you give it to a machine learning model, and the machine learning model uses that, gives an output, and that output is reflected back onto the web page. So I've given three values here: 10, 38, and 45, right? And I click on predict probability, and I get the probability of fire occurring is 0.03. And it makes sense because I had kept the temperature 10, which is a cool environment, and the oxygen content was low and humidity was moderate. So for a forest fire to take place, you need high temperature, high oxygen content, and a low humidity. So let me show you the code behind this. If you learn this, you can create any machine learning model. You just have to learn how to get data from your website and give it to a machine learning model and get it back from there. So forest.html is the web page that I've created. Don't worry about the code. I'll give this in the description. It's very easy. You can get ready-made templates from sites like Material.css and Bootstrap. You just have to understand from where you have to send the data to your Python program. Alright, so I've created a form from here where the form tag starts, and in action I've written /predict, which basically says that whenever I click the submit button, all the form data will be sent to this URL, and the form data will be sent in a post request. Alright, so I have three inputs, one for temperature, oxygen, and one for humidity, right? So these are of text types, all of these inputs, and I've created a submit button over here. Whenever I click the submit button, the entire form data is going to be submitted to the URL of predict. So I have to make sure that I've defined a machine learning model over there. So before showing you the URL for predict and what happens over there, let me show you the machine learning model. Just let me show you the data set that I'm using for this problem. And this is a data set. Basically it has three columns: the oxygen, temperature, and humidity value, and based on these three values it's going to predict the probability of fire occurrence, right? 1 or 0. And the area doesn't really matter. I have not even filled out all the column values. What matters is how the oxygen, temperature, humidity is related to the fire occurrence, right? So what I've tried to do over here is whenever the oxygen value is high and temperature is high and humidity content is low, I've given fire occurrence is 1, right? And fire occurrence is 0 when we have a low oxygen content, a low temperature, and high humidity value, right? Because for a fire to occur, you need to have low humidity, a high temperature, and high oxygen content, right? So I filled out this data set of 40 rows according to this logic, and I expected the machine learning model to learn this relationship on its own, right? That's the goal. So you can use any data set you want. I've just used this for an example. So coming back to the Python program, I've imported NumPy and Pandas libraries and the logistic regression from sklearn.linearModels and the train test split function, and use the import warnings module to ignore any warnings that might come up in the program, and use the pickle module. So pickle is a package which converts the data in your Python program into a serialized form, so that it can send all the objects in the program in a serial manner, one by one, to whoever is going to use it, right? So this will make sense when we come to that line in the program. So we start off by reading the CSV file using pd.readcsv and convert that data into a NumPy array. Right now I've taken the x value and taken the y value from the data sheet. So I've explained all this in my previous videos, so I'm going to just skip this part over here, because this video is how to deploy the model, not how to create one. But still, the basic gist is that we're extracting the x and y from your data sheet and converting that into integer values over here. We're splitting the data set into test and training size, and the size of the testing part is 30% over here, which says 0.3. And we're calling the logistic regression model, and we're training the model using logistic regression.fit and giving the training set as the input, right? So this was, is if you want to check, so this line is not So now that you have trained your logistic regression model, you want to import it into a pickle file, right? So we don't want this entire Python program to run again and again whenever you're using the website. So we train the logistic regression model once and importing that model somewhere else, right? From where you can directly fetch it. So that's where pickle comes in. So when we write pickle.dump, we write what we want to dump, which is the logistic regression model, in a file called model.pkl, and WB is basically in write mode, so it can write onto that file. And if you want to open that file again, we use this command to load something from the pickle file, pickle.load, and we have to write open and whatever the name of the file you have created. RB is basically in read mode. So over here, you just have to take the machine learning model, you have to dump it into a pickle file. This is the main part of the program, right? And it creates a .pkl file over here. Now coming back to the main program, which is your app.py. This is your general Flask program. You start by importing three libraries, your Flask render template, comma request. You import your pickle library, you import numpy as np, and you create an instance of your app. Now you have created the machine learning model and stored that in a pkl file, right? So you have to import that from here. You do that using pickle.load and store that in a variable called model. So this is the default function that gets triggered, which is hello world, and we've opened the HTML file of forest.html whenever this URL gets opened, right? So next we have to define what happens when we get the form data, right? The form data is sent to a URL called /predict, and inside the define predict function, we'll define how to get the data from the form, right? So we create a list called int features, and what we're doing over here is for x in request.form.values, we're running a for loop in all the values in the form of the request, right? We're getting all the form values, the oxygen, temperature, humidity, converting that into a list, and we're converting all the values into an integer because that's in a text format and you need an integer format to give to a machine learning model. So we convert that into an integer over here and convert that list into a numpy array in this line using np.array. Next, we have to submit this variable called final to our prediction model, right? So the model was stored by the name model. So we write model.predict_PROPA, right? Which basically predicts the probability for any logistic regression model. It will give you 0.8, 0.9, whatever the number is, right? So we make the prediction and save that in a variable called prediction. Next, I create a variable called output, which what basically does is it formats your prediction value and gives that up to a 2 decimal place. Alright, so now what we're doing is if the output is greater than 0.5, we want to send an alert that the forest is in danger, right? Probability of forest fire is greater than 50%. So what we're doing is we've created a placeholder in the forest.html file over here below the submit button called PRED prediction, right? So we can insert any text over here. So if the probability is greater than 0.5, we're returning the forest.html file, and instead of predict, we're writing your forest in danger and probability of fire occurring is whatever the actual value was over here. Similarly, if it's less than 0.5, we return your forest is safe and probability of forest fire occurring is whatever the output was. And now simply, if name equals to main, we run the app and just click on the run button, and you should get a URL where the server has been created. So you click on it and the page gets opened up. You enter any value, say I enter a high temperature and a good oxygen content, say 48, and a low humidity value, which is a very strong indication of a fire taking place, and I get the probability of forest fire occurring is 1, right? So that's how it works. So in this way, you can import any machine learning model you want. So hope this video helped you. If you did like it, do like, share and subscribe. And I'll be bringing out more tutorials of this type for Flask interfacing. So do subscribe. And yeah, thank you for watching.